Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and healthy and learning new things daily. Students, in today's video, I have covered the science chapter 1, that is living and non-living things. Students, now look inside your house. Go outside and explore. You can find different kinds of things. You notice that nothing around you is the same. So, in this video, you have learnt about the natural and man-made things, difference between living and non-living things, and common features of living things. Now, look at these things. Do you know who makes these things? These things are man-made. So, the man-made things are things made by people, not by nature. These things are called man-made things. All man-made things are non-living things. Do you know why? Man-made things do not breathe, they do not grow, move, eat, or have senses. Now, look at these things. Can people make these? People can't make these things. These things are created in nature. So, natural things are things that are found in nature and are valuable to people. These are called natural things. Natural things may be living or non-living. While people, animals and plants are living things, the sun, the moon, the stars, the mountains, the water and the rocks are all non-living things. So, what are living things and non-living things? All living things have common features that make them different from the non-living things. For a thing to be living, it has to show the following characteristics. Like, it has to eat. It must move from one place to another place. It must grow. It must have babies. For example, plants and animals. So, let us learn all about those common features that living things share. The first feature is all living things grow. Have you seen your pictures when you were a baby? You don't look anything like you did then. You were very small. You have changed a lot since then, haven't you? You were a baby. Now you are a child. In a few years, you will grow up to be big like your mother or father. Animals and plants also grow. Chick grows into a hen, while a puppy grows into a dog. A small plant grows into a tree. Does a stone grow? Do your toys grow in size? Watch them for a few days. They cannot grow because they are non-living things. Now the next property of living thing is all living things move. Why do living things move? They move in search of food, shelter and protection. Dogs and cats walk with their legs. Fish swim with the help of their fins. Birds fly with the help of their wings. Snakes crawl on their belly with the help of their scale. They do not have feet. Insects move on their legs. Even plants move in their own way. As a plant grows, the stem moves upward. A bud opens to become a flower. A sunflower moves always towards the sun. So it is common for all living things to move. But non-living things cannot move on their own. A boat moves, but it needs someone to row it. A car too moves, but it needs someone to drive it. Can a table move from its place? No, it can't. You have to move it. A bicycle cannot move unless you pedal it. Now, the next characteristic is all living things breathe. You need air to live. You breathe through your nose. Many animals also breathe in air through their nose. Fish breathe in air through their gills. Insects take in air through tiny holes present on their bodies. Plants take in air through tiny holes called stomata on their leaves. But do your books and doll breathe? Do stone breathe? No, they don't, because they all are non-living things. Now the next is all living things need energy to live. You need energy to live? Where do you get it from? The food you eat gives you energy. You also need water to survive. Animals also get energy from food and they drink water. Plants also need energy to live and survive. They make their own food in the leaves as they cannot move in search of food. They take in water from the soil for their needs. Now try to feed your doll. Does it eat food? It doesn't, because it is non-living thing. Non-living things do not eat food. They don't drink water either. Now the next characteristic is all living things respond. You laugh when you are happy. You cry when you are in pain. Plants and animals also respond like you do. All living things have senses and are aware of things around them. But does your doll feel pain when you pinch it? Put your doll on some ice cube. Does it feel cold? When you kick the football, does it feel pain? No, it doesn't, because it cannot feel. Non-living things cannot respond to things around them. Next is all living things reproduce. A dog makes puppy. A fish lays egg, which changes into small fishes. A cat has kitten. A bird lays eggs. Baby birds come out of eggs. A mother has babies. Plants also make new plants through seeds. So all living things can reproduce. Can your toys lay eggs or have babies? They can't, because they are not living things. Can you tell me the difference between living and non-living? Yes. Now, let's classify living and non-living. Tree. Does it eat? Yes. Does it move? Yes. Does it reproduce? Yes. So, it is living. Table. Does it eat? No. Does it move? No. Does it reproduce? No. So, it is a non-living. Tiger. Does it eat? Yes. Does it move? Yes. Does it reproduce? Yes. So, it is living. Umbrella. Does it eat? No. Does it move? No. Does it reproduce? No. So, it is non-living. Computer. Does it eat? No. Does it move? No. Does it reproduce? No. So, it is non-living. Kids, now watch this video 2-3 times and try to understand the concept of living and non-living. I hope you understand this. So, keep learning, keep smiling. Bye-bye.